could this be the final year of operation for the historic Saco Drive-In? The Drive-In's manager says without some significant financial help from the public, it may have to be, and it's all because of the costly but necessary switch over to digital. News 8's Steve Minich has more in this Project Economy report. Steve?
Well, Megan, it's a dilemma facing small theaters and drive-ins all across the country. In fact, here in Maine, we've already seen one theater in Bethel shut down because it could not afford the new digital equipment. And neither can the Saco Drive-In, so it's asking for your help.
I mean, this literally is going to be a fossil by the end of this year.
Ryan Russell manages the Saco Drive-In. He says replacing this fossil will cost upwards of $90,000. But if he doesn't, Russell fears this historic drive-in's upcoming 74th season will be its last.
It looks like it's going to have to go how all the other drive-ins are going, and that would be closed.
Most bigger theaters, including Portland's Nickelodeon, have already made the switch to these state-of-the-art digital projectors. Starting next year, movie companies will no longer produce reel-to-reel films, releasing them only on these high-capacity hard drives.
They plug directly into either a projector or our control center here.
Russell knows the clock is ticking. He's already launched a social network campaign and found local business owners to help back an array of fundraisers planned throughout the summer. He's counting largely, he says, on his 16,000-plus Saco Drive-In followers on Facebook.
If just our Facebook fans, it would take about $5 from each person. So I think that's definitely an accomplishable goal.
As the drive-in's manager, Russell's financial stake in the theater, he says, is minimal. This effort, he touts, is strictly personal. Russell grew up in Saco, and saving the movies means saving memories.
I grew up in a low middle income family like everybody else around here. This is what my family could afford to do, and I'm dedicated to preserving that.
Now, Russell isn't the first theater operator to ask for help. At least two other theaters in Maine, one in Booth Bay, the other in Damariscotta, are both open today thanks to the public pitching in to buy the new digital projectors. Live in the studio, Steve Minich, News 8.